If you want to know how to taxidermy a mouse, this video is for you. This is gonna be nasty. I mean, the gore is gonna be like... This video is disgusting. I mean it. If you don't want to see the gore, you need to click the link now. Bye, I'll see you next time. This is a one-time thing. Also, keep in mind, I've been doing this for about 2 months. This is how I do it.
I know that following instructions can be hard.
All right, let's see. English side ruined. Must use French instructions. Le grill? What the hell is that?
Oh. So I came up with this easy-to-follow acronym. Slice them and create Born Again Mouse.
S!
Set up! You get your stuff, you get your stuff. These are my taxidermy tools. I use tweezers, pliers, wire cutters, an X-Acto knife, Sculpey-Clay, gloves, paintbrush, a place to mount it, scissors, little glass eyeballs, pins, galvanized wire, thread and needle, styrofoam, borax, paper towels, and polyfill. Lacerate, down the spine or down the belly.
Part the fur with your fingers, either on the back or their belly. Be careful not to lacerate into the body cavity. It just gets a lot messier that way. Nice clean cut straight down from right between the shoulder blades down to the tailbone.
Insert!
Insert your fingers underneath the skin and start to pull back. You'll want to work your way around the body cavity until you can see from one side to the other.
Cut!
Pull the pelt back to expose the ankle joint. You'll need to create some tension to get to the end before you make your cut. If you pull too hard, you could remove the joint or the whole foot.
Use your wire cutters to snip through the ankle and wrist joints. That will allow the feet and hands to stay with the pelt. Expose! Pull the pelt back to expose the tailbone, then use your dominant hand to get a good grip at the base of the tail. Tail! Use your fingernails on your non-dominant hand to roll back the skin over the tail while keeping a firm grip with your dominant hand. Eventually, you'll feel the skin loosen up and the tail will pull free.
Head!
You'll need to make some very precise cuts to remove the face from the body. This might be a good time to change the blade on your knife.
Ears and eyelids!
Pull the skin back over the neck and up over the head until you reach the ear canals.
Recognizing the anatomy can be tricky. You'll know you've reached the ear canals when you see little white arches sticking up.
When you see them, make clean cuts through both. Be very careful as you inch forward on the face. This is a delicate spot. When you see the eyes, you can cut into them to get through the eyelids. Just nice, clean cuts. Always cut towards the body that you're going to leave behind and not towards the pelt. You don't want to rip anything.
Mouth!
And!
Nose!
In order to keep the nose, whiskers, teeth, and lips on the pelt, you want to inch back very carefully until the skin is pulled taut. When you can't get any further, take your wire cutters and snip diagonally through the jaw.
Did it! I did it real good. Bump, ba-dum, bump, 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 ba-da-da-da-da-bump.
Clean your instruments and your workspace.
You can keep the bodies for reference if needed. Otherwise, go ahead and dispose of them. Rinse! Rinse the pelt under water. You don't need to use soap or conditioner. Just set aside then in a wet paper towel to keep it moist. Preheat your oven to 190 degrees Fahrenheit. Anatomy! You can use the anatomy of the body that you've set aside as a reference to form the Sculpey head and the Styrofoam body. I like to draw a sketch before I begin. That way I have the design in mind that I want. You can also take a photograph of your mouse. Consider the posture that you want the mouse to be in when you set it up. Do you want it more curved because it's sitting? Straight because it's standing? Those things are going to matter when you're forming the Styrofoam body.
Then I use a beige Super Sculpey to form the head. You can look off of your picture or the design sketch to help you make the shape correct. Treat yourself! Power up! Empty out! Freshen up!
Eyes! I use 3mm black glass for my eyes. With the pelt inside out, you'll want to line up the nose of your Sculpey head with the actual nose of the mouse, turn it over so it's fitting just right, and then go ahead and place your eyes in between the eyelids. That way you'll know exactly where to bake them when you bake the head in the oven. Don't forget to add 2 1-inch long wires into the head. That's going to help you attach it to the Styrofoam body.
Put the Sculpey heads in the oven. You'll need to leave them in there for 25 minutes at 190 degrees Fahrenheit.
Borax! You need to borax the crap out of the pelt. Rub it into every single crevice, including the tail. Off! You need to use a paper towel to rub off the extra flesh stuck to the pelt. You can re-dip in the borax as needed.
Move and reconstruct. Remove the head from the oven. While it cools, you can start stuffing your tail. You'll need to put a little bit of borax in the tail. I like to put a thin wire in the tail, scoop a little borax in with the back side of my tweezers, and kind of move the wire up and down to get that all evened out. Then you'll want to take a tiny bit of poly fluff, squeeze it with your tweezers, put it in the tail, pull back out, and shove it down to the tip with the wire. Always start with less than you think you need, otherwise it will expand and you'll get a bottleneck effect. For more information on the tail, please see my blog post.
Knead! Do you need a break yet? Too bad. Time is ticking and you need to get your mouse sewn up and posed before it dries. Once dry, it is no longer pliable.
Align and attach. Start with the pelt inside out. Line up the nose and roll it over the head. You'll want to make some adjustments and even tuck in the eyeballs where necessary. Get a little tool and make sure the eyelids are just so. That way the eyes really pop. Now you can attach your Styrofoam body to the head. Make sure you line up the wires so that you have the posture that you want. Wrap the pelt around the Styrofoam to make sure it fits. Loose fitting is better. The pelt will shrink when it dries. Galvanize! I use a 22-gauge wire to do the arms. You want to feed it through the back of the Styrofoam body. Make sure it comes out right in the area you want, so you can feed through the little arm, up through the palm, and once it gets to the underside of the palm, right through the fingers. Lead it along just like that. I've used my pliers to make a little hook on the back side of the wire so I can stick it into the Styrofoam and it stays in place. Now I'm taking a little polyfill and pushing it in to add a little bulk. You do the exact same thing for the legs, but with a 20-gauge wire. It gives you a little more support. Add and activate. Add poly fluff as needed to fill out your thighs, arms, and body. Activate the good old baseball stitch using a matching thread. You're going to go up one side and then up under the skin towards the other. I work it from the tail to the head because there's always some sagginess in the tail, and this way you have the power to kind of pull up. Insert. You want to insert the wire legs into the mounting material and pose your mouse. There are different materials you can use as a mount. If you're using foam board, they'll push right through, but if you're using wood, you'll need to drill holes. I use a 1/16-inch drill bit to do the job. Now take selfies. Show the world what you've done. Make sure you pin the mouth shut while it's drying. If you don't, the skin will pull back and it'll dry with its mouth open, looking all gnarly and mangled. I take these straight pins and just really carefully go through the lips to keep the two together from side to side and the bottom one up towards the top.
Oh!
Open! I like to take tape to keep my toes and fingers open or curved in the position that I want. If you don't, when the mouse dries, everything will just shrivel up. Use a stiff paintbrush to smooth the fur out. If you need to get the paintbrush wet a little bit first, that might help remove any extra borax.
S!
Sigh! Take a sigh of relief. Everything turned out all right.
Cans!
Oh my God!
There was no bin, it was full of cans!
Are you sure?
Yes. Yes.
Oh my God!
Hey. Entertain! Show your friends what you made.
She's so lame. Super lame. This is embarrassing. Like seriously. No, seriously. Hello, my name is Sarah. That's Sarah with no H. Too bad if you don't like it, cause haters gonna hate my stepdad Gary. He tries to act so cool. Every time we see him, my friends and I say ew. Like seriously.